Good Wednesday morning. I'm Mike Trim.
I'm Ashleigh Walters. Felicia's forecast is in less than 2 minutes.
First, the morning's top stories, and we start with more than 150 people turning up at an open house to talk about a growing number of glioblastoma cases on the Treasure Coast. WPTV uncovered nearly 50 cases of the rare brain cancer across St. Lucie County during the last 5 years. It was last night that experts from the Department of Health talked about people's concern. Researchers say they haven't found a cause, and some are pushing for environmental testing because the only known cause could be radiation.
This morning, jury selection picks back up for the trial of the man police say killed his 2-year-old foster child in Palm Beach County. Investigators say Tristan Adams had internal bleeding in 2014, likely from being hit. They say Michael Beer was the only person with the toddler when he stopped breathing. Beer's attorney calls the prosecution's case speculation.
A local well-known restaurant manager is now wearing an ankle monitor. Javier Gonzalez hopes a last-minute appeal in federal court works. Otherwise, he'll be deported to Mexico next month. He's been living in the U.S. for the past 20 years with a clean record, manages Pizza Al Fresco on Palm Beach. He has an American-born wife and 3 daughters. Only his oldest, who's 11, knows what's going on.
This morning, you can't go for a swim at DuBois Park in Jupiter. The county health department issued the advisory after water samples came back with increased levels of bacteria. The department said the recent heavy rain is likely to blame. Well, now the waiting game begins for those future samples to show the water is safe. Felicia?
Thanks a lot, Ashleigh. The first thing you're going to notice as you step out the door this morning is the humidity. It is uncomfortably muggy as we start off our Wednesday. Heading into the afternoon, scattered rain and storms. Highs once again today in the upper 80s, and then a few showers lingering around early in the evening and then clearing out. Your hour-by-hour rainfall showing rainfall remaining fairly low, just stray chances through about lunchtime. Then as we head into 2, 3, 4 o'clock, we start to see those rain chances jump up a bit. Rain chances about 50% this afternoon, and then a little lower Thursday and Friday, and then a little bit lower this weekend. Your Father's Day forecast looking good.
Thanks, Felicia. Don't forget you can get that weather all the time to your smartphone. Download our free WPTV mobile app.
Make it a great day.